Welcome back to another episode of Shaymen Legends, and we're on episode 13, and I'm joined by a legend. It's Lee Gregory. Lee, how are you doing?
Hi, Luke. I'm good, thanks. Some good memories there.
Yeah. How's it going at Sheffield Wednesday then? Now, obviously, you've got Ipswich tomorrow.
Yeah, no, I love it. I'm enjoying it. I'm back home in Sheffield. I enjoy it, so it's it's good.
What are like the differences between like training facilities, etc., with obviously Halifax Town and obviously Sheffield Wednesday?
Well, at Halifax, we used to train on 3G Asher turf on a Tuesday, Thursday night. So it is a little bit different. It's a little bit different, but the training's not too much difference.
Yeah. So what was it like, obviously, when you first joined the club? Obviously, you came on loan from Mansfield before you made it on a permanent basis. What was that like coming into the club? Obviously, you were full time at Mansfield, and then you came and dropped down to part time.
Yeah, to be honest, I didn't really know much about Halifax at the time. So it was something that I didn't know what I was walking into. But I think I was there for a month, and we had I think it was like 10 games in a month or something like that. But as soon as I walked in, They had a good set of lads there when I came. Good set of lads, and they made me feel welcome from the start.
Yeah, obviously being the club record goal scorer, what does that mean to you?
Yeah, it's nice. It's just watching your video back then. It's some good memories, and I loved it at Halifax. I absolutely loved it. Everyone knew that. So it's nice to watch.
Yeah. Obviously, when you first came into the club, we were in quite a rough patch. We just reformed. We brought in players like Jamie Vardy, Matty Pearson, Lee Gregory. Why do you think it was we had so many quality players at that time?
I just think the recruitment. I think Neil Aspin, who obviously brought the lads in, he knew what he wanted, and he knew how to pick a good lad from different teams, and managed to bring them all together and obviously achieved very, very good things.
Yeah, obviously got back to, you took us all the way back to the National League where we still are today. Was that your ambition at first, or did you expect to go even further or even less? You just expected to try
get a promotion? To be honest, when I first come out, I was just hoping to play games.
Yeah.
Obviously, I've come on loan from Mansfield. I was just hoping to play a few games, score a few goals. Never expected for it to go out like it did, but the moment I went there, from the first game, I was like, I want to come back here next year. Thankfully, I did. And then it was like, we never expected to go from where we was to where they are now, actually. But even so, when we got there, we was like, we wanted to get back into the Football League. And I was absolutely gutted that we didn't get over the final hurdle. But it's good to see that they're doing very well now. I keep a lookout every week, so hopefully they'll step over the line this time.
Yeah, it's great to see how we're doing at the minute. What's your opinions then of, obviously, Neil Aspin as a manager did great things for us, like you've explained. We brought in a lot of quality players like Jamie Vardy, yourself, Matty Pearson. What was that like working under Neil Aspin?
Yeah, he's very good. Obviously, he brought me some Halifax. I loved the way he did everything about the training, the games. He could motivate you, even in the toughest changing rooms. When you go into some not so nice changing rooms, and all you want to do is just get in and out as quick as you can. He was a good motivator, and he helped us a lot.
Can you talk us through the Blackley year then? Obviously, we actually got promoted. There were some quality players in that team. Obviously, you scored in the final when we got promoted. There were a brilliant save from Matty Glennon. Talk us through that season as a whole.
Like I said, we just had a good set of lads that everyone wanted to be really successful. And we just worked so hard for each other. I think that's the difference between other teams, is most teams have got a few individuals that are really good, and but they don't really gel together. Our team was just, everyone was on the same page, page, and we could put that on the pitch. And when you've got players like, for me as a striker, when you've got players like Dan Gardner, Paul Marshall, Scott McManus behind you, who's creating chances for you, it makes your life a bit easier. You've got Adam Smith, and when he came later, obviously in the Conference Prem. So it was good. It was good.
So what's your thoughts then, obviously, back when you were at Halifax? Obviously, the fans pushed on quite a lot. Obviously, there were some games we were going to, like, Ossett Town away. What was it like having that away support behind you?
It's massive. It's massive. And obviously, I never really saw football like that until I went to Halifax. I never really played for Mansfield, so I didn't get to feel that and see that until I went to Halifax. And I think that's why I loved it from day one. Fans are great, home and away. So it was good to pay back the fans with winning leagues and getting promotions and stuff.
There were a lot of great games, obviously, at your time at Halifax. Obviously, that Cambridge season, we almost got there, almost got to the Football League, obviously, got knocked out in the playoffs. It was looking like we were going to go through, obviously, to Cambridge with you scoring. What was that season like as a whole for you?
Yeah, for me, that was up there. Was one of my best seasons that I've had. Loved every minute of it. Like I said just before, I was absolutely gutted that we didn't get over the line. I actually think with the squad we had, we should have, looking back. But obviously, everything happens for a reason. So it was, because obviously that was my last season as well. So it was a bit upsetting we didn't get over the line. But all in all, it was a really good season. Really good season.
29, I believe it was 29 goals in that season for you as well. Very, very good from you.
I thought it was a bit more than that, but
might have been.
I think it was 31, I think. I'm not sure, though.
What's that like then? Obviously, you scored quite a lot of goals that season. It was a great season as a whole. Obviously, we didn't get through that final hurdle, which was a little disappointing. But I don't think with, obviously, the financial situation we were going under, obviously, etc., we were expected to get back to the Football League in that season. But thinking back of it now, some of the players that we had that season, we probably should have gone all the way.
Yeah, I think, but then back then we didn't have, you didn't know that the players were going to go on to achieve what they achieved. Obviously, me, Mark Roberts, Pearson, Maynard, Liam Hogan. Did Hogan, was Sir Hogan still with us then that year? So we've had a few lads that were, have gone on to do a lot higher now. But yeah, looking back now, we should have gone all the way.
Yeah, obviously you were committed to Halifax. Obviously, in that final season, the January transfer window, there were obviously a lot of clubs behind you, and you were committed to stay and try see the season out and try get us promoted. Obviously, Halifax fans made the song up. We got Lee Gregory. We still sing that to this day in certain games, but we sing "You're Not Lee Gregory" instead now, which is, I'm sure you're very happy to hear that. But
Nice.
What was it like, what was it obviously like being so committed? I'm sure there were a lot of clubs after you at that point.
There was a couple of clubs, but nothing out of, obviously, no, nothing really come of it. But I was just happy just to crack on and hope. Obviously, back then in Jan, that we just, chances were to get promoted, and that was my main aim. Yeah, there was a few clubs, but nothing really come of it. So I was just happy to stay.
At the time, did you expect, obviously, certain players like Matty Pearson, Jamie Vardy, to go so far in their career?
Jamie Vardy to go on, not as as far as what he's done. It's unbelievable what he's done. But Matty Pearson, Matty Pearson had the determination. He had everything going for him. And then Mark Roberts, I knew he was going to do get higher. To be honest, there's a few players that I thought were going to do better than, I won't say better, but I would say go higher than what they did. end of the day, that's football, and that's what happens. Yeah.
Like, I'm guessing that's like, obviously, Scott McManus's, etc., who obviously was also very committed to the club. And that was what was so key for that team at that point. There were so many players who could have easily gone on to play for bigger clubs the January transfer window, but they sticked it out until the end of the season. Scott McManus stayed so long. Obviously, you are the club's all-time record goal scorer. And that is probably because you stayed at the club so long. You stayed for quite a number of years to say your qualities that you could obviously offer to Halifax Town. And I'm sure a lot of clubs were obviously sniffing after you for a number of years when you were obviously at Halifax. What was it like for you then? Obviously, you had a hand injury for quite a long time and you still carried on playing. What was that like?
Yeah, it was one of them. You don't play football with your hands. Well, I was a striker, you obviously don't, the keeper you do, but so it was just, as long as I was pain free and I could protect it, then I was always going to carry on. I was unlucky enough to do it twice, and but I was just, as long as I was pain free, I was happy to crack on.
Obviously, when you went to Millwall, what was it like going to Millwall? Obviously, you're a Yorkshire person. You've obviously lived in Yorkshire for the majority of your life. What was it like going all the way to London to play for Millwall? Obviously, a big step up as well, wasn't it?
It was tough. It was tough. I'm not going to lie, it was tough. And obviously, Millwall are renowned for the fan base and stuff. And it was, the first year was tough. But I found my feet quite quickly and I ended up like Halifax, loving every minute there. And I have podcasts with Millwall still now, like I do with Halifax. And I said the same things. Halifax and Millwall are the two clubs for me that stand out to be the best.
You've been a fan favourite at many clubs, haven't you? Obviously, Halifax and Millwall. You even won Play of the Year at Millwall, and you're currently Sheffield Wednesday's top goal scorer so far this season. What's it like then? Obviously, at the start of your career, did you expect to, obviously, when you first signed for Halifax, to obviously be where you are now?
No, not at all. To be honest, I actually thought I'd still be in non-league and playing part-time football. I don't know, has Halifax gone full-time?
We have gone full-time,
Have you gone full-time?
Yeah.
I might go back then. No.
He's actually a question as well about that.
I know, I didn't expect... to be honest, I expected to just be non-league my whole career. Yeah. But I enjoy football, so I didn't mind where I played as long as I was enjoying it.
Well, that's finally for my questions. We've got a few quick-fire questions and then we'll move on to the fans' questions. There's been a lot of fans who obviously sent questions in, so unfortunately, we won't be able to answer them all. We've got some in the chat as well that have just come in, but first we'll go on to the quick-fire questions. So the first one is, what song gets you in the zone for a game, for your game?
I would say Kanye West, All of the Lights.
Moving on.
Go on. Yeah, go on. Go on.
Next is your pre-match meal.
My pre-match meal consists of a little bit of pasta with pesto, bit of cheese, salmon, bit of veg, and then some fruit. Not too much.
No, not bad at all. Who was your best mate at Halifax then?
I wouldn't say I really had any best mates, but
yeah,
who I was close to was the lads we used to drive in with. So Mark Roberts, Jonathan Hedge, Vardy, Danny Holland. I'd say them.
Jonathan Hedge, we actually asked Jonathan Hedge when he came on the show that question. He did actually say you were his best mate at the club, but he said he said similar to you that the squad were all together at that time. There were no people really left out, which is obviously great to see, and that's probably why we were so successful. Moving on then, highlight of your career, not including Halifax?
Was probably winning at Wembley for me. Getting promoted.
That with Millwall.
Yeah. So that's the highlight up to now.
Yeah. The next up we do have, let's move on. Sick. Who was your boyhood team?
my boyhood team.
Yeah.
My boyhood team was Sheffield United.
I wouldn't tell Sheffield Wednesday fans that. I'm sure.
Everyone mm-hmm. asks. I don't mind saying. Mm-hmm. It's different when you're playing football. It's end of the day, it's a job, and you want to be successful in everything you do. So mm-hmm. if it means I'm successful with Sheffield Wednesday, then so be it.
Mm-hmm. So at this moment in time, who do you prefer? Are you still Sheffield United?
Like I said, no, not mm-hmm. really.
Does it change when you're a footballer? Like obviously, there's like really Jamie Carragher, he's supported Everton, he's now Liverpool.
Yeah, it really does. My little boy, he's Sheffield Wednesday mad. It's not a thing for me. As long as I'm enjoying it, I don't mind.
Mm-hmm. Next one is, who inspired you as a child, like a football idol?
So when I was younger, I always had the same name on the back of my shirt, and that was Brian Dean at Sheffield United.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Always had his shirt, always had his name, always had his number.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I would say him.
Mm-hmm. I think that's it for the quick fire questions. We've got some questions in the chats. We're also including memories, etc. The first one in the chat is from Rob Brown. He says, is that a Halifax Town shirt on the wall behind Lee? Is it?
It is, yes. It is, yes. Mm-hmm. That one, yep.
Mm-hmm. The next one is from Paul Walsh. He was obviously at Halifax for a long time. What was his favourite pub in the town?
I can't remember what it was called, but there was a nightclub in Halifax.
Yeah.
I can't remember what it was called. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I had some good times there. I had some good nights there.
Who did you like go out partying with then from Halifax?
We all used to go out. That's why it was so good. Everyone mm-hmm. used to go out. It was never just one or two. Everyone used to go out. Mm-hmm. So that's why we were so close, and mm-hmm. that's why we achieved what we did, because we were just, the togetherness was second to none.
It's similar to how it is now, obviously, under Pete Wilde, who under all the players go out together when they're going out partying, going out for a meal, etc. And it's been quite a traditional thing at Halifax Town. There's never really been a squad that's divided, which has always been great to see. We'll move on to the questions, obviously, from the chat, obviously from the social media now. Which town goal does he consider the most memorable? That was from Ross Baker.
It's the playoff final goal.
Mm-hmm.
and obviously just watching the video back there, that brought back some good memories. And that one stands out always. And there's a couple. The one at Geisler.
Mm-hmm.
In the semi-finals.
Mm-hmm. This good. One from Positive Shaymen. Lee was part of some of the most memorable moments of FC Halifax Town. Garforth, Lancaster, Geisley, Brackley, etc. What was his favourite? Obviously, Garforth was a very good game, obviously, when we came back. Which is your personal favourite?
My personal favourite?
Mm-hmm.
Again, I think it's going to have to be the playoff final. Just going down to there and getting the 1-0 win, and then the journey back and stopping off at the pub, and so everything mm-hmm. about that day, not just the game, but everything about the day, I'll remember that forever.
Mm-hmm. The next one comes from Lee Casalino, I think I've pronounced that right. Any funny dressing room night out stories and his thoughts on Aspen as well. So are there any funny dressing room stories or night out stories?
There was. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So was it the first time or the second time? I think it might have been the second time. So I was there. Mm-hmm. I was there for the month. Got promoted. Yeah. The year after, we got promoted again, mm-hmm. and we went to Magaluf, mm-hmm. and obviously a promotion party.
Yeah.
And we got there, we chucked our stuff in the room.
Yeah.
The room was, the guy behind the desk was like, would you like any safe for your passports mm-hmm. and money and stuff? We were like, no, right, thanks. We'll just, mm-hmm. we'll sort it out. Went downstairs, went to the bar, come back later on the day, everyone had been robbed. Everyone took, no one had any money left. It was the first day, no one had any money left. You got Jonathan Edge, he walked into a lamppost, yeah. Cut his eye open. So yeah, some funny times.
Yeah. The next one is from Ian Shaw. Being a Sheffield United fan, what possessed him to go to Wednesday? And we need goals at the moment. Is he busy on Saturday? So what did actually possess you to join at Sheffield Wednesday at the start?
Stoke wanted me to leave the club. And I had a couple of clubs that I had the choice to go to, but Sheffield Wednesday is a big club. Obviously everyone knows it's my hometown.
Yeah.
And I wanted a different aspect, and I thought, do you know what? I'll give this a go. And it's turned out to be the right decision because I absolutely love it here, and I'm hoping that I'll be successful here as well.
It's a big club with a quality fan base, Sheffield Wednesday. Yeah, I bet that's obviously brilliant, isn't it? Obviously, going away, you go as far as Plymouth and they're still selling out. What's that like?
Yeah, it's a fan base it's probably the best I've actually been involved in. Obviously, my friends, my family as well, are all Sheffield Wednesday fans, so it's good. And there's actually more pressure on me to deliver, because if I don't, I get not only to get stick from the fans, but I get stick off my family and friends as well. Yeah. So it's good fun.
This is from an anonymous person. It's saying, "What are your plans to do after football?"
So I think I never actually thought about this until about a year ago. Mm-hmm. But I think I'm going to go into coaching. I think.
Links in with this other question here. This is, would you ever consider rejoining Halifax? Would you consider as a coach, maybe?
I'm coming back as a player when they get into League Two. So, of course, I would love. I'd love to come back. I loved it at Halifax.
Yeah.
So if I can have any connection with them, I would love that.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be great if you could come back when win League Two. We'd start climbing up the leagues then and getting the whole squad back together. Yeah, it'd be great to see. The next one is, we've got a few memories as well. For example, we've got this one from, where is it now? This is another question. Does he still speak to Vardy? And when is he coming down to watch a match?
I speak to him now and again, not loads, but now and again we have a conversation. So next time I speak to him, I'll ask him to get down to the Shea to watch him.
Do you come to the Shea?
I've not been for a while. Obviously, when you're playing, you don't really get the chance. So
yeah,
I wanted to go to the Chesterfield game, but I didn't have time to go.
Is that the away game?
Hopefully, I'll get down soon.
Is that the away game?
Yeah.
Scott McManus came to that. He was on the drum.
I saw on his Snapchat.
The next one is, this is a memory, this from Martin Davies. Can't believe he gave his hat-trick ball away at Hyde to my daughter. Still got the ball and it's signed. Great player and a great guy.
Can I have the ball back, please? Nice.
I'll ask him. I'll try contact him.
I'm only joking. Mm-hmm. I'm glad she's enjoying it.
Yeah. What was it like then, obviously, that Hyde game scoring a hat-trick?
Obviously, scoring in any game is nice. But I think that was a little bit better because there was so much about that game. Everyone was like, oh, Hyde, you're going to batter you, this, blah, blah, blah. And we just turned up that day. And thankfully, we got the win and the match ball.
This is from Nathan Wright. How does he rate his time with us, and how was that influence in his career he's gone on to have?
Massive. A lot of, I would say my proper career started at Halifax. It was massive. And like I said before, I loved it at Halifax. So, it's one of the best clubs I've been at.
The next one's another memory from Martin Fawn. Wish him well, enjoyed the banter with him while I was working for Meat, and great mention, and Grit mentioned me to him. Cheers. And that is Martin Fall. This is another memory. Andrew Walton, a quality striker, turned his career around with the Shaymen, and his strength and determination paid off, and his Football League career took off. Thoughts on that?
Yeah, he's right. Mm-hmm. My career never really started until I went to Halifax. So I'm forever grateful.
Mm-hmm. The next one's from Frank Chilset, I believe. I fancied Lee Gregory to start scoring goals, so I sponsored his shirt. He immediately did the business, became one of town's top players. Coincidence or not, very proud to have recognised his talent and delighted to have shaken his hand. Lee, a top bloke and a Shaymen Legends. Thoughts on that?
Cheers, mate. Well, mm-hmm. I appreciate all support, so thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. The next one is, this is from Flea. Lee, who's your favourite Spice Girl and why?
Baby Spice, I'd say.
The next one's from John Barlow. Does he think we will get in the playoffs this year or gain promotion this year? That is from John Barlow.
I think you'll win the league this year. Ooh, I hope you win the league this year.
We've just lost two games on the bounce. I'm off to Dagenham tomorrow. Be great to see. If Sheffield Wednesday up for it, you could always come back on loan.
I know, yeah. Well, I'll ask the gaffer tomorrow.
The next one's from Rob Brown. Introduction starting in long league and progressing rather than joining a top team's academy as a youngster and staying there. What's obviously it like? Obviously, you were obviously at a top side. You could have easily gone to another top side, but you came all the way down to non-league. What was that like?
I never really enjoyed football until I went non-league. And I think that's what kick-started my career.
Yeah.
I just didn't agree with everything that was happening in academies and obviously I never achieved what I wanted to. So going to non-league was the best way for me. Mm-hmm. I think if I'd have stayed at academies or whatever, I might not have gone on to what I've achieved.
This is another one from Rob Brown. Please also ask him when he realised he was good at football, when did you realise you obviously had potential to make it so far up the football pyramid?
I don't know. When I was really, really young, and I've got older brothers, so I always used to play football with my older brothers and their friends. Mm-hmm. And they were always saying to me, oh, you're by far better than anyone I played with. And that was like 5 years younger than.
Yeah.
So maybe back then I knew I had something. But I had that many knockbacks in football from age 14 to age, when they go to Halifax, 20. So for 6 years, I had a lot of knockbacks. Yeah. Never thought I'd make it and stuff. But like I said, going to Halifax was the best thing I did.
This is another one from Lee Casolino. Other than Vardy, who was, in his opinion, the best player he played with at the Shay and why?
I would say Dan Gardner.
Mm-hmm. Dan Gardner.
He had something. And unfortunate for him, he's had a few injuries. Knocked him back a bit. But he was the ultimate number 10 to play in front of. I said Dan Gardner.
Now before we end the video, we've got one last question from Rob Brown. Now this is one we ask every single Shaymen legend who comes on. Obviously we've had 13 people on. One person has failed. Can you name all the clubs you've played for in order?
All the clubs I've played for?
Yeah, in order.
In order? From what age?
We'll say youth career because it's a little harder then.
Right, so from youth career, I was at Sheffield United.
Yeah.
Then I went to a place called Totley.
Mm-hmm.
Then I went to Sheffield FC. Then I went to Staveley. Then Mansfield. Then Halifax.
Yep.
Millwall.
Yep.
Stoke.
Yep.
And Sheffield Wednesday. That's excluding loans.
Oh, yeah, excluding loans.
Yeah.
I don't think I can give you that. From what? Stoke, then where did you go next?
Well, I didn't go. I went on loan to Derby, and then I went to Sheffield Wednesday. But if we're doing loans, then I'd have been like, from when I was at Mansfield, I was at Blackwell, Harrogate, Halifax. So that was excluding loans.
Well, I'll allow you to pass. The only person who hasn't passed is actually Jonathan Hedge. Lee, I really appreciate you coming on. I know you'll probably have a busy schedule at the minute. Obviously, you've got Ipswich tomorrow. I do wish you the best of luck. My mate's a Sheffield Wednesday fan, and he asked me to tell you to bag a hat-trick tomorrow. So hopefully you do. Pardon?
I will try.
Okay, I'll tell him that then. Thank you for coming on, Lee, and I hope the best of luck tomorrow.
Cheers, mate. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.